trying. Tell me, are you fighting?
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Episode number 17 of The Good Life. I'm excited to be with you again. My name is Jimmy. I'm counting down, my people, because 17 weeks straight I've been here, and I've been loving every second of it. I've been loving every second of the opportunity to share with folks principles from the Word of God that will bless, inspire, and help you go to that next level in life. Last week we was here. We was at the Ensign, baby, and I wanna continue here at the Ensign because I know the challenges of life. This week in particular, I went through some major faith tests, and I'm still fighting. And I want you to understand something: we don't walk by what we see. We don't walk by the signs, literal signs, or what folks call this is a sign, this is a sign. I want you to focus on the promise of God's word. That is what you ought to seek. That is what you ought to look at. Regardless of the circumstances, we keep moving beyond the what? The end sign. And today, two principles. I'm not going to be with you long. Two principles, man, that I believe that will bless you, inspire you, and help you go to that next level in life. Now, we talked about David last week. We talked about Ziklag. We talked about how he had to go out. Even though all these things happened to him, he had to encourage himself in the Lord. And the key to that was the third point we left off of, was that you had to have a mantra. You had to have something that you said to yourself. Now, in our life, we understand that we have to have the Word of God. We have to have something that we can focus on regardless of what we see around us. And I said before, we move beyond the end sign when we have faith in our heart. Now today, two principles we're gonna talk about: dealing with challenges, dealing with what happens when we're right here at the end of the road. Two things I wanna say. Number one is you have to be patient. Now I'm gonna slow down because patience calls for it. I want you to be patient. Patient means that you are understanding that what I'm entering, the fact that I'm moving beyond the end sign, means that there will be times when things won't turn around on a moment's notice. It's not the moment's notice that you're focusing on. It's not how soon will it change that you're focusing on. You must focus on the promise. You must focus on your destination. You must focus on where you're going, not how soon it turns around, because you can get so caught up into how soon things will change that guess what? Nothing ever changes, because you are still focusing on the sign, on the end sign, on what you can see around you instead of the promise. I want you to focus on the promise. Why? Because what's around you is around you. The sign is here. That's not changing. So we already know we can't impact what we see right now, what we're experiencing, but we can impact what's going to come around the corner, what's beyond the end sign, what's in the trail. That's where we're going. We want to receive, we want to see something that has nothing to do with the circumstances around us. We want to see the promise of God's word come to pass. And understanding patience is the key. Too many times right now, we live in an age where everything is so quick. I mean, I check myself many a days on a commute home because there are times when you know you got, I'm gonna tell you, the test of patience is on your commute home and going to work. Are you able to be patient behind that car that took 3 extra seconds? Your day was not changed by 3 seconds. But these are things that we face on a daily basis that interrupt our practice of patience, interrupt our practice of perfecting patience. It's the fact that we live in a microwave society. We live right now in Wi-Fi. We can go anywhere in the world and get access to the internet. I mean, if it takes 10 seconds, we're frustrated. We want a new subscriber because we are so used to things happening in a moment's notice. Things in life do not happen in a moment's notice. God's promise is going to be based on faith in your heart and your ability to stick to it. Are you following me? The second thing is this: I want you to know that you are strong. That's where the promises come to. The promises come to those who are strong. you think about David. David's at Ziklag. He comes back. All his men are there. They ride in, and they see everything demolished. They see everything burned. You got 600 men that's mad at you, that want to kill you, that want to stone you. So he goes, he encourages himself in the Lord. He comes back. He could have easily said, you know what? This is it. This is it. I mean, I'm giving up. Forget it. Forget it. And they would have been right outside out of David, outside of David's tent, ready to take him out. Let me tell you something. You got to know that you're strong. Strong is what's on the inside of you. You have to know that the greater one is in you. Regardless of what you are feeling right now in your body, what you're feeling in the circumstances, in the pressures of life, man, it's do or die. Strength is do or die. You have to be strong enough to know that if I'm not strong, I'm going to die. It's not an in-between. It's either you're strong or you die. It's just that simple. David had to be strong or he was going to die. Life with us, either we're strong or we're going to die. I'm not talking about literal dying physically, but I'm talking about, you may be in a circumstance where that happens, but I'm talking about is your ability to win, your ability to have a sense of life, in a sense of achievement, in a sense of accomplishment. That comes when you are strong. There's a story about a lion cub that got lost. And some sheep found this lion cub. And this lion cub grew up with the sheep. And when the sheep were bad, the lion would bad. And the lion grew up bad, walking around with the sheep, mellowing with the sheep, and playing with the sheep. And one day a lion came out to attack the herd of sheep. And something inside of that lion that grew up with the sheep stood still. The other sheep ran, he stood still, stood his ground. The lion came up to him and he roared. He said, "Roar!" And the sheep, or the lion that grew up with the sheep, said, "Baa! Baa!" The lion roared again, "Roar!" And the lion that grew up with the sheep, "Baa! Baa!" And this went on for some time. And finally, the lion that grew up with the sheep let out a roar. And the other lion roared. And this lion that grew up with sheep, that grew up around people who were not strong, circumstances that came about, and the same people they hang around with run, would talk about the challenges of life, would talk about how they couldn't win, would talk about how it's going in, and how all these things are dismal, and there's no hope, and what are we going to do, and all these things he grew around, but he had strength inside of him. And I know I'm talking to people who got some strength inside of you, and I know that there is a lion inside of you. I know that the circumstances of life cause you to roar, causes you to scream and let out your ability, let out who you really are, and that's strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Believers, you gotta rise to the occasion, baby. You gotta remember that there is a greater one. The line of the tribe of Judah is inside of you. You have to get to a point in life where you know I either am strong or I'm gonna die. And let me tell you something, the strength of the one inside of you won't let you die. Keep you standing on your toes. Keep you in that ability to look at the lion, to look at the sign, to look at the terror that's in front of you, and stand there and let out a roar. Baby, it's a good life. Episode number 17 is to a close. Remember, don't allow the circumstances, don't allow what you see to impact who you are. I want you to know you are strong, you are mighty, you are great. Could care less. I want you to say it out of your mouth. I don't care how bad it looks. You are great, and the greater one is in you. There's no challenge, there is no test that you do not come out the winner. Today is your day. Episode number 17, episode number 18. We'll see you next week. I will holler at you, my people. I love you, and beyond a shadow of a doubt, the greater one is inside of you. Peace.